you ever waited a really long time for something? Sometimes when we are young, it might feel like it is taking so long for us to grow up. Is it ever going to happen? Well, yes, it will come eventually. You just have to wait. In a similar way, we have hope that Jesus says he is going to return and come back for us one day. But what is taking him so long? Today we will talk about Jesus' return and hopefully give you some wonderful hope and good news of his return. While we wait for him, we have a job to do. Let's make sure we are telling others about Jesus as well and keep meditating on God's word. Let's meditate and spread the message found in Acts 4:12. This is our last week with this verse. I'm sure you know it by now. Let's say it together. Acts 4:12. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Acts 4:12. Now, since you know it so well, I want to hear you say it without the words. Acts 4:12. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Acts 4:12. Today's story comes from letters that Paul wrote to the people of Thessalonica. Those letters are the books of 1st and 2nd Thessalonians in the Bible. Ready to dive into our story? Here we go. About 20 years after Jesus died on the cross and rose again, Paul traveled to the city of Thessalonica. The people there worshiped idols. Some of them even worshiped the Roman emperor. Paul told the people the good news about Jesus, and many people believed in Jesus. Paul started the church in Thessalonica, but some people did not like Paul's teachings, and they forced him out of the city. Paul was concerned about the people of Thessalonica. They had not been believers for very long, so Paul sent his friend Timothy to see how they were doing. Timothy brought back good news. Even though the Thessalonians faced suffering for their faith, they did not give up. Paul wrote a letter to encourage the believers. He told them that Jesus will return someday. On that day, Paul said, believers will no longer suffer. This message gave them hope. Paul wrote to help believers in Thessalonica know what is true and teach them what happens to friends who had died. Believers can grieve with hope. Because Jesus died and rose again, God would bring with him those who had died if they trusted in Jesus. On that day that Jesus returns, the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a shout. These believers who have died will be raised to life first. Then believers who are still alive will be raised up together to meet the Lord. We will live with him forever. No one knows when Jesus will come again. The day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night when you do not expect it. So be ready. God has promised us eternal life. He has saved us through his son, Jesus. Whether we are alive or dead when Jesus returns, he will bring us all home with him forever. So continue to encourage each other because we have this future hope. The prophets in the Old Testament told about the day of the Lord, a day when God would come to judge the world and save his people. Paul said that in the future, on the day of the Lord, Jesus will return for his people and judge the wicked. Believers live with hope, knowing that Jesus will come again. Now, we have been waiting for Jesus to return for over 2,000 years now. So you may be wondering, what is taking him so long? Well, first of all, let me explain that Jesus tells us in Matthew 24:36 that no one will know the day or hour that he is going to return. No one. It could be any time. And with all the pain and hardship and sin in the world, it's okay for us to want Jesus to come right now. But we have a loving and merciful God. Jesus is waiting for people to trust in him. He's giving more people the chance to be saved. Every day that passes is Jesus lovingly giving someone a new chance to put their faith in him. That way, when Jesus comes back, more people can spend eternity with Jesus instead of apart from him. Those of us who already believe need to be living every day with urgency and purpose, realizing that we have to tell our family and friends and anyone who doesn't know Jesus so they can believe in him.